accomplish that.
And sometimes you have plays for that. It's not all.
Sometimes you just have to concede to the defense, and they know what you're trying to get done, and to try and get any more than that is almost.
Inside the 15. A big play there for KC. And even 50 yards. The red zone.
Defending a deep route, even when it's thrown on time, is very difficult. But when he's able to maneuver outside of the pocket, that's almost unfair. He's bought extra time. His offensive line has protected him. And now when the ball's in the air, the guy downfield has a chance to make a better adjustment. That's just wrong on every level as far as the defender is concerned.
On second down, Jamal Charles. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. Just a 1 yard pickup there, and it's going to make it third down at 6. He'll set out on third and 6. And this play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So the offense took the timeout. Looks like they're ready to go as we get set to resume the action. And Santos able to put this one up and through. It's good. And that will make our score 9-0. Well, not content with a first quarter lead, I guess. They're going to go onside kick. So he splits the uprights there, and I would imagine it's nice as a kicker. Right when it leaves your foot, you know it's good.
Yeah, it's kind of like a golfer that picks up his tee after a nice drive without even watching it land.
Solid analogy. I like it. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. Good job by their defense, though. They held him to 3, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than 3. And that's exactly what happened.
You think
there.
That factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
On second down, here's Romo. He finds his target, Terrence Williams. Touchdown, Cowboys! Terrence Williams, 45 yards. And the Cowboys have cut it to within a score.
I know these wide receivers are about flash and dash and high-flying plays, but a good number of them played running back at some point in their career, and that's how they finish off a lot of their big plays. Run after the catch.
And this time he finishes off the big play in the end zone. And they're back within a couple at 9-7 now. One play, two plays, touchdown. That's all it took there. A very short and sweet drive that got him in the end zone. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. Now the Chiefs offense, they get ready to hit. On the field. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 point.
The kicker.
Exactly. You put it through the post, that's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that'll help him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Bash.
Super toe.
He's going to let this go deep, back over the middle. And it's knocked away and incomplete. Demetrius Harris, the intended target. And now it's third down. Looks like the defense in press coverage here.
I know the initial focus was on how far that pass was downfield, but how about the coverage on the play? Able to stay with him, get his hands where the receiver's hands were going to try and catch the ball, tips it up in the air, and knocks it away.
Jeremy Maclin, the intended receiver, and it brings up fourth down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
That's pulled in at the 32. Almost outkicked his coverage there. Punt, but 10 on the return. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. Here's the Dallas offense now heading back out onto the field. And they're going to need another score. Got one last time, but still down here.
When you're playing catch-up, every possession becomes crucial, doesn't it? It's vital. Get back out on the field, punch in the end zone again. They know it's not easy, but what they do have going for them, they did score the last time. They think they've got a good formula working.
And what about the defense?
Well, now you're just saying to yourself, okay, we gave up a score last time. What adjustments do we need to make to slow them down now and get the ball back for our own offense? Is it more pressure? Is it more zone? What do they have to do? They're trying to figure that out themselves.
We'll see if they can figure that out right here. Cole Beasley, the intended target, and it's third down.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. As a down, both sides know they absolutely have to win. And the name of the game for the defense is pressure on the quarterback. But pressure on the quarterback with contact, that's how you end up winning it.
And the pressure gets to Romo as he goes down. Derek Johnson able to drop him for a loss of a couple. And partner, I'm not really sure what in the world they were thinking on fourth and long there at this stage in the game, but you think social media may be firing up a little bit right now?
Oh, the coach is trending right now. All right, there's no doubt about it. People wonder what that decision was. But it takes me back to a number of years ago. A very successful coach in the league had told himself before a playoff game he was going to be aggressive. No matter what, he's going to be aggressive. And it ran his team into some real problems early, and they got upset in that playoff game. Let's see if this team can recover.
Well, that's aggressive in capital letters with glitter, 7 underscored. I mean, that's the definition of aggressive.
Yeah, you can almost hear the cheerleaders doing the be aggressive chant behind him, and he listened to it. Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game. Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
And Santos able to put this one up and through. It's good. And that will push the lead up to 12-7. A little bit of a lower trajectory there on the deep kick, and it worked.
Had to do it because he had to drive it out low because of the length of the kick. Able to do that, got it above the defense and over the post.
Well, not content with a first quarter lead, I guess. They're going to go onside kick. And the Cowboys are able to recover. So an onside kick fail in the first quarter. Not sure I completely see the logic there.
It's not apparent, is it? You almost have to go deeper, I think, and maybe if we try and work along with them and speculate a little bit here, they must feel like they need to steal possessions in this game. And maybe they don't match up possession for possession with the opposite team. They got to steal it and try and gain an advantage. And they tried. They just didn't get it done.
Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit. First down, it's Romo. And on the left side, he's got Witten. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
Seeing that play and understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, Makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? What a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. They lost two there, and it's third down. Well, they try to swing it on left into the flat, complete, but really nice open field tackling.
And they played that one like a great boxer. They were on their toes on that one. They weren't back on their heels reacting to the play. No, they saw it, came right for it, and made a nice tackle for lost yardage.
Third down and three. Try and run for it with Elliott. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up fourth down. 3-4 defense, usually here you'll see the linebackers come up, make those plays, but the nose tackle also vital.
Well, it's so vital because what you just pointed out, normally he eats up blockers that allows the linebackers to get to the ball carrier. In this case, he did his job and then some, and there was no gain at all for the runner.
And Bailey able to knock it through. And that will cut the lead down to just two. So a good kick there, and they finish off the drive with three.
And that should be the goal for an offense. Finish each drive with points. So that's a nice job there to come away with at least something.
Now after the field goal, Bailey will kick it away. This is fielded at the goal line. Oh, good hurdle. Look at the spin. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. And out come the Chiefs now. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see. Catch made right side by Wilson. And all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. Albert Wilson, 66 yards. And the Chiefs. Strike quickly here for 6 points. Cairo Santos on to try the extra point. And that makes it a 9-point game. Those are the kind of drives they like on offense, from the coordinator to the quarterback, the line, everybody. One play drive and into the end zone for six. Are able to recover, and that's why you have your hands team out there on the field. Those are the best guys ready to make that play.
And let's face it, it was executed well. It wasn't a bad kick. It wasn't anything like that, just that the normal outcome actually came to play. Analytics would tell you it's a very low possibility of getting the ball for the team kicking it in an onside kick situation.
You're all about the numbers, aren't
all
you?
All about the numbers, baby. It's a new game now.
They don't lie. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. And a nice carry there of 15 yards.
I don't want downplay the run, but that's exactly what I expected out of him coming out of college. When I look back at my draft analysis, one of the highest-rated players on my board, a three-down back who can do everything. And one of the best parts of his game is what he does when he doesn't have the football, because he carries it really well, but he blocks equally as well as pass protects for his quarterback. I think he's going to be special.
Now Elliott, and he'll get a couple here down to the 22. The All-Pro Justin Houston in on the tackle.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of two. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Give him three on the run there. Now they're looking at a third and about five.
Tough day. Tough sledding right there. And it's been that. Way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there.
Ready, right, 20. Right, 20.
From the gun on third down, Romo. He completes it to Bryant. And he won't have the touchdown, but he will have the first down as he's tackled at the two. That's connection numero uno, Tony Romo going to Desmond Demond Bryant.
And how about the chemistry those two have built up over the years? You know, everybody always sees Dez as being so demonstrative on the sidelines, like he's upset about things. He just wants his quarterback to know he wants the ball, and he's going to make plays for him.
And here we go on first and goal. And this one will wind up with him losing yardage back to the four-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
Now, that was a terrific play. We're down here near the goal line, and only one word comes to mind for me, and that's overwhelm. Because they absolutely overwhelmed the offensive line. He came free and made the hit in the backfield.
They'll try again with Elliott, and he'll get in. Touchdown, Cowboys. Ezekiel Elliott, a three-yard touchdown run. And the Cowboys draw a bit closer. And they're able to run it in. It started with a battle in the trenches. They won there, and they got in for 6 points.
And that's going to be a tough one for the defense to deal with. They've got to go to the bench now and figure out how we're going to slow down this running game, because on that particular play, they had no answer.
On the return, it's Niall Davis. Comes Kansas City, and following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, to see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the
last
time.
That's true.
I mean, that's what you work on.
And that's caught inside the 30. And all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. Albert Wilson, 77 yards. And the Chiefs strike quickly here for 6 points. That's a heck of a start.
The game underway, essentially. I mean, there's a long way to go. If I'm on defense, I've got to figure out how to slow this guy down. Because when one guy shreds your team, That's demoralizing. Make him spread it around at least. But right now, he's showing no signs of slowing down.
Protection was great. He had time to set up a campsite. But in the secondary, though, they were ready.
And I think that in most places on the field, if you have that much time to throw the ball, someone's going to shake free and you'll find an open receiver. But condensed near the goal line on a two-point conversion, all that exit, you know, there's not any extra field. So it kind of closes in on them, and that allows you to cover a little bit better.
And the Cowboys are able to recover. We put our attention now on the Chiefs' defense. They struggled that last drive. They were kind of hit two ways, both with the run and the pass.
And I love how you brought hit into it, because a lot of defense coordinators like to show a little cut-up film the night before a game. They usually have some boxing in there, and it always shows the guy being the aggressor, the guy on his toes punching, not back on his heels taking punches, and that's where this defense was in the last possession.
They were on their heels. Will they be on their heels again? Let's see.
It's a tried-and-true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. On second down, Elliott. And there just continues to be nowhere to run. He's bottled up again at the line of scrimmage. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
The defense won that play so fast that I think if the running back even had time to notice if anyone was there, it was just a blink of an eye, and there was a loss on the play.
Here we go, here we go. Left 35.
Throwing on third down, Romo. And that's caught by Beasley. And he gets the first down here as he's taken down at the 24.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks, because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going to
ask you, that wasn't the primary target. He's so good at that, isn't he? Sitting alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, as it is Cowboy football to begin quarter number two, but they face a second and long to start things out. They come out here in the eye. Again, it's Elliott. And his rough afternoon continues. He's going nowhere again. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Back-to-back runs that were stacked up. Offensively, now you've got to think to yourself, do we change blocking assignments? Do we change formations? Do we change looks in order to try and get the running game going?
Let's go now. Right 18. Right 18.
They'll fake the give. Now Romo. And the Chiefs are going to get him. Justin Houston coming in to drop him for a loss of 8. And it'll be fourth down.
Now we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway. But when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
Personal foul, roughing the kicker, defense.
And this is going to be roughing the kicker, an inexcusable penalty, Charles.
You've worked so hard to hold him to a three-point kick. Now you give him the ball again with a chance for a touchdown.
After the penalty, it's Elliott. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. It's a loss of 4 there, bringing up second down. And the Chiefs are going to signal for and be granted another timeout. That's their second, so they'll have one remaining here in this second quarter. We'll be right back. Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive.
Here we go, here we go. Black 35. Black 35.
Here's Romo now on second down. He's got time in the pocket. Looking for the end zone. And oh, not only did he drop it, he dropped it in the end zone.
You can feel the anguish all the way up here. It certainly looked like he had that one in the end zone, open, unable to hold on to it.
And the Chiefs showing a dime look as they defend this third down. Third and long here, it's Romo. And this pass is going to be incomplete. He was looking for Terrence Williams that time, and that'll bring up a fourth down. So now on fourth down, Romo off, Bailey on for the field goal try. Made his first, this now from 42 yards out. And Bailey able to knock it through. And that'll get the lead down to 5. So in the end, they had the ball for 10 plays, but the drive only yields 3 points.
Yeah, they were able to move the football, but the defense stiffened once their backs were to the end zone, and they were able to hold them to just 3.
And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Alex Smith and the offense heading out for their next possession. And how about the start so far, Charles? 3 first-half touchdown passes.
And that's how you generate excitement on a team. You keep your offense moving at a really high level. And it's also how you establish leadership by playing that well. 3 touchdown passes.
That's caught at the 25. It's a big play there for the Chiefs. And even 50 yards. A great job pulling that one in from a guy, as we know, who can really blaze. He's got a lot of speed.
And that speed can work for him so many different ways. Sometimes he just takes off and goes and just runs past people. Sometimes you get people to back off so far that you can catch everything underneath. But still, at some point in the game, you probably have to make some contested catches, right? Sometimes you have to go up and beat a defender for the football. He has that in his arsenal as well.
Showed it right. There. In the red zone this time. 5 wides in the game. 4 of them to the right side. Here's Smith now on second down. Rolling to his right. Trying to drop one in, but it's incomplete. Chris Conley, the intended receiver. Third down here.
Whenever I see an in route dropped, as we just saw in that play, I'm always thinking that in the back of their mind, they're worried about what's coming at them because they're going towards traffic on that route as opposed to being away from it and maybe having a little bit more space.
Charles, the low setback. And he'll get it up the middle. And he is going to lose yardage here. He lost 2, and it brings up 4. The third and inches, tried to pick it up the middle. He had nowhere to go, tackled for a loss.
And you know how we talk about double A-gap pressure, meaning linebackers going in the gap between the center and the guard on either side? Well, it's not always to get to the passer. Sometimes you do that to prevent a running play. Worked pretty well in that situation.
Oh, it's dropped. He couldn't hang on. That would have been a big interception. Instead, they'll have a chance to get three. The Cowboys offense heading back out and ready to go again. And last time able to get three. It's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six. On second down, here's Romo. It got his man complete. The 20, 10, 5, and he takes it down deep into enemy territory.
I know that in recent years, it's been tough on Tony Romo. A lot of injuries have piled up, but he's still able to sling it, Brandon. Look at that throw.
Yeah, he can. By the way, you know his given name on his birth certificate?
Hit me.
Antonio Ramiro Romo.
That flows.
He's got a good ring,
well,
so I'm going to start calling him Antonio.
The lyrical one.
They come out here in the eye. To throw on second down is Romo. And too much on that one. It's out of the back of the end zone, incomplete.
And it's a first half that leaves us anticipating what can still come. I mean, two touchdowns already here through the second quarter. There could be plenty more before this game is over.
And he knocks it through. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Alex Smith and company heading back out there now. You know, normally he's probably pretty happy with his performance at this point. He's played pretty well. Bottom line, they're down on the scoreboard, so I'm guessing he's not that happy.
No, the fantasy owners who have him for this week, oh, they're happy with what's going on. But for him leading a team, trying to win a ball game, I agree with you. Not happy at all. Trying to figure out how to up his game and inspire his teammates to do the same.
That's a true leader. Play fake for Charles. Now Smith. And now he'll turn and off his back foot. Now a clash of bodies here and it's intercepted. Picked off by Orlando Scandrick. And his crew will take over with a football at the 35-yard line. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
And he's just going to get rid of this thing. To no one here, he throws it away. And now it's third. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. And with that, they're now out of timeouts. And still plenty of time remaining here in this second quarter. From the gun on third down, Romo. He's got his man. It's Williams. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. A gain of 32 that time.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning. Losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
Yardage back to the 34-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
To me, that's a superior play by the backer because he was allowed to, I think, run free on it and make that play. His defensive linemen, they cover things down for him because offensive guys, the linemen, what they're trying to do, as you know, is block the guy at the point of attack and then climb to the next level and get the linebacker. And you're not allowed to climb. You got a free hitter, and that's what we saw there. And a really nice play resulted for them.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. Here's Romo. And that is incomplete. So now here comes the field goal team for the third time today. From the right hash and call it an even 50 yards. And Bailey able to knock it through. And that will push the lead up to 5. So that one is his third of the game. Now, if you're wondering, that's only halfway to his career high as he once had 6 field goals.
Brandon, but with 6? Let's hope we don't get that again, please. Okay, can we see a few touchdowns here and there?
That'd be nice. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. And now here comes Kansas City. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities. When offenses dial up big shots downfield, they're not always for the guys out wide. Sometimes they want to go to their big target deep downfield, and the defense breathes a sigh of relief. 50-50 balls, not easy to get away from the big targets.
Well, he just threw an interception last drive, nearly another pick.
And things aren't very even right now, are they? It's a little bit sloppy out there, isn't it? It's kind of different driving on those paved roads. And those country roads that have those potholes in them, isn't it? Because that's the way this game's going right now. A lot of bouncity bounce to it.
You spent some time on some Tennessee country roads.
I certainly have. Plenty of family back there. God love them.
The 3 straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on 4. Well, they've had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively, and then just continued there with that incompletion.
And definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. Those stop troops, they're enjoying things right
now. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Orlando Scandrick. And the return out shy of midfield to the 46-yard line.
And that's now the second time he's picked off a pass here in the first half alone. Again, another great read defensively, and you just see him get in the right position to make the play and get his guys the football back.
After the interception, here's Romo. Throw right side, complete to Williams. And he gets this one all the way down inside the... offensive group. One man on the backfield, Elliott. From the red zone now, Romo. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Derek Johnson in there to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon.
It's interesting, partner, that most defenses try and guard the 35-yard line actively because they think the way kickers are nowadays, about a 52-yard field goal, they're kind of giving up points. But you get even deeper into territory, you get into the red zone, they're going to guard it even more, which means more pressure, more blitzing.
That one goes for 24 yards.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
Now Elliott. And Charles, at some point, you can't keep worrying about big play. Can this be perfect? You just have to get the ball out of the end zone.
And in the offensive huddle, that was discussed when they called the play. Just get out of the end zone. But you know what's interesting? A lot of the times in the defensive huddle, they actually call a set and then say at the end of it, get a safety. So it's preached, it's coached, it's thought about. Now that's the kind of return you're looking for. To get to that spot on the field, that allows you to do a lot of things on offense.
And now here comes Kansas City. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Off of play action. Here's Smith. Now he'll let it go deep right side. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
And the third down pass falls incomplete.
Oh, man, for him to be that wide open and drop it. Sometimes you have just too much time on your hands, right? You end up thinking way too much, and your hands get shaky.
And yes, he's a tight end, but that's a catch he should have made. Here's Smith, escaping the pressure right. Now he's going to throw deep right side. And this is incomplete. Scratcher there, and Dallas, they'll take over in terrific field position. Well, that, my friend, I guess is the definition of a head scratcher. Fourth and long, this stage of the game, what were they doing?
I just have to believe that he looked at the situation, still in the first half, decided there's a time to be aggressive. Now was it, because there's still time to make up for it if things don't go right. Of course, a lot of questions on this one, and look, I want to go for it as much as anyone.
But fourth and long?
Yeah, I don't think I would have there. That one seemed a little bit on the irrational side.
Fans might be a little angry at that one. And do not ask me to explain. There, folks, that's a safety in the strangest of ways. My word. Well, Charles, I've heard of backing up to avoid the rush. I think this takes that to a whole new level.
And not upper level either.
This is taken at the 18. Comes Kansas City, and last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on fourth, turned it over in their own territory, but the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold
up. But he
up.
Trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think that that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it. Be aggressive, because I've got the Wild Bunch backing me up over here on my own sideline.
Now we'll see what his offense can do. And both guys were there, but it falls incomplete.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about 5 or 6 plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays, and you don't get many opportunities to dial them up, and they just did, and they drop it with a great chance to make a big play. That's going to hurt.
Now he's going to throw it back deep over the middle. Incomplete. He had his hands on it but couldn't pick it. But it's now fourth down.
I know that interception was dropped, and it would have been their third of the game, and I will guarantee you, in the huddle, on the bench, defensive guys have been talking about is we've got this guy right where we want him. Who's going to get the next one? It almost becomes a challenge, and they've missed a golden opportunity.
This is taken at the 15. Good coverage there. An even 50-yard punt leads to a return of 5. And out will come the offense as they take over. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And the last time they had the football, they surrendered 2 points on the safety. They don't want to do that one again.
No, not at all. It's almost like a bases clearing double, isn't it? Give up a couple of runs.
Sure.
just messes things up for you offensively. But now they've got to go ahead.
I don't know what was going on there, but the end result. This is going to be a safety. I'm not totally privy to what went on with their offensive meetings, but Charles, something tells me that one wasn't in the plan.
Yeah, when we had our production meeting, they didn't exactly share that with us, but I'm pretty sure that on the play sheet, the run backwards into your own end zone play was not written down. At some point, we're going to get it through our heads. Special teams, special teams, special teams. The spark that often wins games.
The Chiefs offense now making their way back onto the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play. He's got to be kicking himself right there. His team's already picked off 2 passes. That would have been the 3rd in the game. And boy, they've really played well attacking the football.
They'll roll him out right. And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. A big play there for KC. 48 yards. And we continue to see another example here of offenses just going for it.
And this game has really turned into a receiver's dream and a defender's nightmare, because no one's being stopped throwing the ball downfield, and points are going on the board.
Touchdown, Chiefs! So a quarterback scramble, certainly a pass play, but he saw something, tucked it, and got in the end zone.
A lot of quarterbacks, when they scramble, they're scrambling to create more time to throw the ball downfield. In this situation, as you noted, he tucked it and took off. Great play by him.
And they will line up now for the 2-point try. Here's Smith looking to throw. And this is going to be caught. It's good. And that extends their lead by 2 more. He hits the big target for the 2-point try. Defenses hate those guys, especially around the goal line.
It's hard to decide who you're going to put on him. Are you going to put a smaller corner on him? Are you going to put a safety who doesn't have maybe the same coverage skills? How about a linebacker? He may have the size, but he's not used to really covering in space. That's why the tight end gives you such a great advantage when you're throwing the football.
Now, after the touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And now here come the Cowboys. And last time they surrendered the safety, we know they don't want to do that again.
That is just one of those oddities in scoring that we get. And it's just so strange to see that go up on the board. And then you got to make sure that that doesn't happen to your team again. They've got to take care of the ball.
But, boy, it juices up the defense.
Oh, without a doubt. That's a great way to score some points.
They'll start the drive with Elliott. And he'll push his way forward to about the 32. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher.